And Lucelle Sports Arena, the stunning setting, the brand new WTT Arena these past 10 days. Much more to come, of course, from World Table Tennis. But these 10 days, these two events, the Contender event and this week WTT Star Contender Doha, really has got everyone talking. We've had one singles final completed in this final session of play. Mimarito making it back-to-back WTT titles with victory over Fung Tian Wei of Singapore. The Japanese winning 4-1. $25,000 for it, of course, as well. Winning the title. Another success for her. Building up now to the last match, as I say, of the event. Tomokazu Harimoto, the top seed in the men's draw from Japan against Ruwen Phillis, 42 in the world. Dan, Harimoto we would have expected probably to get to this stage. Not a big surprise. But what about Phillis, the German, what he's managed to do here to get to the final?
He's had an incredible run. I mean, as soon as I saw on the draw, wow, Phillis has took out Junbi Satani 3-0. Zheng Wujin, what's happening here? And then obviously I watched his match against Lin Wenru to win 3-0 there too. And then, of course, to take out Darko Jorgic 4-2. It's just been such an incredible run. And he's been so effective with those long pimples chopping. And, of course, his backhand serve. Yeah. So effective.
Can he go one better? We're about to find out. Let's introduce the players then for the men's singles final. Seeded Japanese involved here in the men's singles final. Is that an omen with Mimarito having already tasted success in the women's title match? Tomokazu Harimoto will look to do similar here in a best of seven duel for the WTT Star Contender Doha men's singles title. Or will this man, who's been surprising everyone this week with the manner of his performances, his victories, we just saw there, Ruwen Phillis, has he got one more big win in the locker? It's in terms of our main umpire, Imad Meheb of Lebanon, Roman Klecker of the Czech Republic is the assistant umpire for this one. The last match of the WTT Middle East Hub. And with the performances, of course, that these two have produced through the week, the star quality that Harimoto brings and the absolute contender ability of Ruwen Phillis. Can we have a fitting finale to this competition? That's what they're playing for in terms of the trophy. $25,000 on offer to the winner of the men's singles title here at WTT Star Contender Doha. $19,000 to the finalists. All part of these rewards, fitting rewards for the best in the sport. More on that to come, of course, as we have more and more WTT events in the months to come. Coin toss. It's Phillis there. I actually just gave the decision, I think, to Harimoto. It can be hard to hear yourself sometimes, of course, the pumping atmosphere of World Table Tennis here in the Lucelle Sports Arena. But he gave the decision to Harimoto here. Begin the warm-up ahead of this last match of the event. Dan, this guy, 17 years of age. Let's look at it in a sense, semi-finals. The disappointment, of course, of losing to Dmitry Ovcharov in those semis. How he's responded to that this week. Look at this run through this draw. Your initial comments on that. So impressive.
The game yesterday in that semi-final between Harimoto and Dmitry Ovcharov, if you haven't watched it yet, be sure to go back to worldtabletennis.com and watch the highlights, because it was some of the highest quality table tennis I've ever seen. Both players just ripping shots, both backhand and forehand. Relentless table tennis.
Yeah, I mean, even if you look last week in their semi-final, of course, he got revenge over the German this time, but the semi-final and the contender event, I think those first couple of games, as good as anything I've seen in the 10 days of competition. Of course, he went on to lose 4-2, got the revenge yesterday to make this final. His opponent, his run's got everyone talking, isn't it? And you've said as well, he made a few point a few times, Dan, with this, that it's been a long time coming in a sense for Ruin, hasn't it? Because in team competition in doubles he's delivered, but in singles this week, this could be the making of him in singles this run.
Absolutely, this really could be the making of him, and it could be something that just takes him to that next level, gives him that belief on a singles tournament scale. I mean, look at the wins there, Zhang Wujin, Mizutani, yesterday with Darko Djurgic, amazing match. And what's amazing with Ruin Phillips, of course, a defender, but his attacks are incredible. He literally attacked past Darko Djurgic. It was Ruin attacking against Darko.
Yeah, and he had Lin Win Ruin ribbons as well in the quarterfinals. And it's the run that's got everyone talking. I think it's kind of defined world table tennis, really, this run from Phillips, because we talk about the unexpected results because of the level of the players who are entered. That's what lends itself to these upsets. Are they upsets in a way because of the standard in the sport? You've got the stars, but the contenders are so good that these results can happen, and that's what we've seen over the last 10 days, and Phillips defines that. Just wonder whether he's got one more in him to top it all against the world number 5, the top seed here. We're going to find out. Will it be Harimoto? Restores a modicum of order at the end of the event here, the top seed with the title. It'll be the underdog here, Phillips, to get the men's final underway. Best of 7, and of course here.
Straight away, Harimoto felt the backspin of Ruin's serve.
First question to you then, Dan. I mean, maybe people tuning in here first time and know about Tomokazu Harimoto, for instance, what he brings to the table. Ruin Phillips, this unusual style. You know, we've kind of talked about he's a defender, classified as a defender.
This is the interesting part. Can Harimoto lift that backspin?
But then you've got on the top of that with Phillips, he's not a pure defender. Mm-mm. He's kind of a hybrid, isn't he? He's a modern day defender. How does he win this match?
Ruin has to...
We're already setting the time.
I'm just curious to just see what's...
Oh, he's out of shot here. So far away from the table there.
Ruin's got to mix it up. Yeah. He's got to mix it up. He's got to keep Harimoto guessing. When Harimoto's got time and he knows what's happening, he's got a rhythm of a game, he just fires on all cylinders. Ruin's got to mix it up. He's got to attack when the ball's loose, which we've seen him do throughout this whole tournament, but also chop low and really well. And one thing with Ruin, his backhand serve is so deceptive. Players struggle with it. So he needs to be dictating the game. It can't be Harimoto commanding.
First towel down then. Saw Yusuke Kurashima, Harimoto's coach there. They would have done their homework on Phillips. It's a very different type of opponent. Yeah, they've met a couple of times before, but you know, if you think of the wins through the week, there's no one, you know, in terms of Harimoto's draw plays like Phillips.
Not at all. And interesting, Harimoto's doing a lot of long, fast serves and straight away playing strong into the body of Phillips. He doesn't want that too much chopping, so he's going straight to the forehand, which is very clever. And we saw that with Darko yesterday. Darko was able to not have Ruin backspin and defend too much. You can see how far back there Phillips is.
Well, I mean, I guess the thing is here, on your point, Dan, what Harimoto's done one of these first few points, you're getting Phillips there. I mean, this is where he's really effective, of course. He can draw the errors. Doesn't really chop when I see him on the forehand side. He tends to basically shovel.
Yeah.
A lot of the time. So what we've seen is from Harimoto there, when he's won the points, is, as you say, he's going into the forehands because he knows he's probably not going to get a chop back from that wing of Phillips.
Exactly. And then he can compete with him in that forehand area. We haven't seen many rallies at all yet where Phillips is just chopping, and Harimoto spinning. Harimoto doesn't want those rallies. He's seen it didn't work with Lin Win Ru and Jun Mizutani.
Oh, it's just fascinating, the matchup. I mean, we love it when two quality shakehand attackers go head-to-head, but it's great, this. The mix of styles, it's what the sport's about.
No, it's brilliant, and it brings a lot of variety.
I mean, if you talk about a shakehand attacker at the top of the game, I mean, Harimoto is right there as among the very best. And you've got Phyllis on the other hand, the defender, the hybrid defender, always taking that step back generally, having put the receive into play. So you've got the contrast there immediately.
4-8.
Nine. The start he was looking for here.
Phyllis going for the attack, twiddling his bat there to use his smooth rubber for the forehand.
Nine, just explain the twiddle as well for those who are not familiar. What Phyllis did there on the previous point, what he often does.
So of course, Phyllis has got the long pimples on the backhand side, the red rubber. And he's twiddling his bat so he can use his smooth side to attack. Because it's very hard to attack on the forehand with long pimples, right? You want to be using the black side. So Phyllis is actually turning his bat in his hand. We'll see it a bit more as the match goes in slow motion after Phyllis does a serve.
Nine.
Good receive there. Phyllis using the long pimples. Did sit up high. It looks attackable for Harimoto, but it's quite hard to read exactly what spins on that ball.
It's kind of wobbling around a little bit as well, off the pimples.
So there's attack. That's the hybrid attack you're talking about, Guy. Now, if we see here, when Ruin serves, he's using the black side, smooth, twiddles. Let's see, the smooth side was used all three shots there.
Yeah.
He's twiddled twice in three shots. And that's what makes it so hard for the opponents, because they're not too sure what ball's going to come back in a split of second. But here it's Harimoto with the two game points.
Jörg Roskopf, of course, a German legend on the bench for Phyllis here. Two game points for Harimoto.
This is the exact ball I was talking about. This is the one that I feel like Harimoto may struggle with. Heavy back underspin from the long pimples of Ruin. It's loaded with backspin. I saw Marlon once struggling against that ball in the World Team Cup 2018, but here we go.
Oh, he's done well there, Harimoto. And he's taken the first game of this final off Phyllis in the end there, 11-9.
See how Harimoto there sent that ball cross-court into the forehand. Kept away from the long pimples, kept away from the red rubber. And Harimoto, the wonder kid from Japan, goes 1-0 up.
Yeah, he's very much the wonder kid, still just 17 years of age. On his way here with the first game in the bag, the top seed in this final. Clash of styles reflected in the head-to-head here. It stands at one apiece coming into this star contender final. 2018 German Open, Phyllis won that, their first meeting, 4-2. But Harimoto won the previous match. That was at the Austrian Open towards the end of the 2019 season. So one win apiece. I mean, that gives Phyllis confidence. And I think actually the talk as well, you know, reading around on the social media at WTT, on our social channels, people are saying that actually over the best of seven here, Phyllis can contend. He can possibly do this. You know, it's not, obviously Harimoto can win this match and his ranking and everything else, but it's not a, you don't look at it in a way, you know, sometimes you come in, Dan, and you go with a player, okay, they've won, say, all seven of the previous matches, and you don't, you try and talk it up. Fans are not really thinking it's serious. Here, you can actually see a case both ways.
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, for sure. I mean, Ruin's got a great chance. He's just got to steady himself here in this game, try and get those chops in a bit more. I feel like when Harimoto's attacking into that forehand, he's effective. Can see this here again. This is what we need more of from Ruin, because then Harimoto's guessing more. He's not as confident. He gets more unsettled. And that's loaded with backspin. It's very deceptive because Ruin's not doing that much motion. It doesn't seem it, but he's got good touch. But yeah, see, this is the issue for Ruin. As soon as Harimoto dives that ball into the forehand, Harimoto's in his territory that he likes. And this is another thing that Ruin does so well, is his backhand serve. He gets so much spin on the ball. I think one of the reasons players struggle is because they're worried about pushing passive, because then Ruin comes in with the attack.
Yeah, well, we've seen his big cuts on the forehand side that he can take. I mean, he's so powerful. Those drives, loops as well. He's just unpredictable as well. They talk a lot about players, they like rhythm. Harimoto wants that true ball coming at him. He wants to get into that position. Phyllis doesn't really give that.
For sure. I mean, Phyllis done well there, blocking with the long pimples. It's not easy to do that. Just couldn't get the angle at the end there. Now, that's the Ruin Phyllis that we know can be so dangerous when he's attacking. After those chops, he's running in. Forehand fade. Harimoto done well to get that back. And that's what we saw in his previous games, Ruin, right? He was so strong with the attacks, and he definitely needs to take this game to Harimoto and make those strong forehands and backhands.
Let 4-2.
Good point construction again from the Japanese. What would they have done beforehand? I mean, we were obviously commentating the women's final. You know, we were getting information through from the training hall and everything beforehand, the practice. When you're taking on, we've talked about what Ruin Phyllis brings. For you, oh, he's got the edge there. Yep, just enough of the edge there, Phyllis, to take that point. What would Harimoto have done, in terms of practice with Yusuki Kurashima for you? What would you have done? You're prepping someone to take on
a
player like Phyllis.
It wouldn't surprise me if Harimoto in the training hall had one of the coaches or a teammate chop, for sure, and have long pimples as well. They have all the bats ready. I've seen quite a lot of training hall stuff, and before the matches, players they also train against left-handers if they're playing against a left-handed play or someone with tricky serves.
7-4.
It makes a big difference, because if Harimoto dived into this match without playing anyone with long pimple bat.
Yeah, because he hasn't in the draw.
No. So he would have definitely used it in the training hall. I'm 100% sure on that. What about that for a combo? Backhand, forehand.
Yeah, this is huge, isn't it, from Phyllis?
You see him twiddling there as well.
Yeah.
On both shots. It's hard enough to play a forehand topspin without twiddling. It's phenomenal. I feel like, Phyllis has got Harimoto where he wants him now. Harimoto's unsettled. He's not too sure what Phyllis is going to do. Harimoto is very good at finishing these balls. When he does catch out Phyllis, Harimoto is very good at punishing him there, Whereas I feel some other players that have played Phyllis this week, when Phyllis has been caught out, they've not been that good at that, playing really hard on that next ball.
Yeah, not clinical.
Yeah, whereas Harimoto is.
8-6.
Well, going again into the chop, into the backhand of Phyllis, and again getting reward in the end there. It was initially into the forehand. Hiera, of course, coming off. This is backhand side in the end. That'll frustrate him. He should be making that. Again, really. I mean, those last couple of points, he's ended up getting the rally where he wants it, Phyllis.
Yeah, just struggling to read the topspin there on Harimoto.
Session of errors on the backhand from the German here.
This is the level of Harimoto. He's so consistent. He's not going to break down.
Look at the reaction there. It's like he's won the title.
An absolute key game, this one, to go 2-0 up or 1-0, 1-0. Harimoto knows how important that is.
He hasn't won the title yet, but if he can take one of these next two, he'll be halfway there, Harimoto. This is an excellent response because, of course, Phyllis was ahead in this second game. Harimoto now with a couple of game points.
Nine, ten.
Backhand really did let him down there in the end, Phyllis. Another mistake, and it's Harimoto now. Two games up in the final.
An interesting run of errors there, really, from Phyllis. Sort of head dropped a few times. Maybe just snatched at a few balls. As soon as Harimoto started that comeback, Phyllis' body language started to change. He started losing out on the short game.
Doesn't look as comfortable, does he, as he's done in this amazing run through to the final. It's got everyone talking. And, of course, that's what they're playing for. Invite your comments, as always. Of course, there'll be coverage. There's been coverage throughout these 10 days. Hashtag WTT Doha. We invite your comments. There'll be a reaction, of course, the best reaction through our social media channels here at World Table Tennis to all that's gone on. Interviews with the key participants, photo coverage as well. Of course, match highlights on the official website, www.worldtabletennis.com. It's been the case throughout the 10 days. It's been quite a ride. And is it going to have this ride, the perfect ending to it for Tomokazu Harimoto? Has Ruan Phyllis got something left here in response? It's been an amazing run. He's now two games down here in this final. Couldn't have a better coach, really, could he, on the bench to try and devise a way back in. Do you feel that there's a need? I mean, Jörg Roszkopf obviously has had a chance to chat with him there. Do you feel that Phyllis needs to change up? You've now seen a couple of games here, Dan. You know, we talked a lot in the first few points about the matchup.
Yeah.
Now we've seen a couple of games. Do you really need to change anything up, or is it just about executing the game plan better?
Mm. Well, I felt like Phyllis did well in the last game. He's 8-4 up, and he really unsettled Harimoto. And he is right now with a 3-0 lead. It's just about not making those unforced errors early on, and whether that's because Phyllis is thinking about the moment, it's just... Can't be giving any too loose balls at the start. So we're pushing out well, getting Harimoto out, and then getting set and being ready to chop or get those attacks in.
See, that's not a bad miss there, because I mean, he set up the point well. That's how he'd like to finish. That's just the lack of the execution from Phyllis, the problem. Yeah, as you say, I mean, he was 8-4 up in the previous game. I mean, he's now ahead in this one. Doesn't seem to be too much wrong in the general approach.
That's it. He's just got to keep that pressure, keep mixing it up. There's a good variation there. And then that forces Harimoto, to make an unforced mistake. He's rushed it into the ball there. Brilliant. That all stemmed from that receive there off serve. Absolutely hacked. That allowed Phyllis to get in first with that forehand. Good legs. Getting nice and low. Look at this guy, 6-1.
Mm.
That's brilliant.
There we go.
So you're talking about variation. This time Phyllis come around the side of the ball on that reverse chop shot there, which then popped the ball up. And then the twiddle. backhand kill. It's just an incredible combo.
Yeah, it's kind of a backhand loop, backhand drive, the way he sets up. Isn't there a real element of surprise about it?
Oh yeah.
Now he's coming here. Now he's coming to the party.
It's amazing how he read Harry Mota there was going to go for a slow shot and then steps in, boom.
2-8.
Foul service there, but still a lead of six, an even better position, of course, than he was in. But he won't be getting carried away, of course. He led 8-4 in the previous game, but this is an even better position for Phyllis. Application required there for Harimoto was something, wasn't it?
That's the first time we've seen a run of points where Phyllis is having to do five or six chops. And I was impressed with Harimoto there, how well he was lifting those balls.
Yeah, with so pressure. Easy to lose concentration there, one of those.
This is where Phyllis needs to be careful, not rushing the point at the start. You know, he's jabbed into it. I know he's trying to be positive, but got to keep the pressure on Harimoto, make him play some shots, you know. Because Phyllis is doing well. I mean, he's holding in the point, especially when Harimoto's going to the forehand. He's able to keep the ball in.
Phyllis here.
It's a timeout.
Timeout.
It's got to be, really, with what happened in the previous game as well. Doesn't want the run to continue.
You can see Roscoff here gets up straight away.
He's seen it all before. He needs to try and halt the momentum there of Harimoto. That was three in a row. He's a bit puzzled, doesn't he, here, Phyllis? Got to keep telling himself, though, the level that he's produced to get in those positions has been very good.
Yeah, he doesn't need to be hard on himself, you know. He's got to keep positive, take initiative, because...
Back into it, and he's still well-placed in this third game, no question.
8-5.
See if that timeout does the trick for the German. Oh, nothing he can do there. It was there, wasn't it? And he kind of set it up in many ways, Phyllis.
That's exactly the combination that has worked so well throughout this whole tournament. Chop, 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 wait for the push and then come in for the attack. It's the moment, though, at the moment for Phyllis. He's feeling it.
Yeah, now the lead's been wiped out. That's six in a row for Harimoto.
Harimoto is so hard to... You know, even when you're ahead, it's same with Dmitry Otchov yesterday. 5-0 up, 5-1 in two games, Dmitry, and Harimoto just comes straight back.
And it's that hunger, that desire. You know, people often, I speak to people, when they watch Harimoto for the first time, they go, why is he shouting like this after every point? Yeah, he's talked about that and everything. It's not a show. This is what allows him to produce his best. And isn't that what it's about? It's about doing what you need to do to produce your best. There again. He's such an incredible competitor, Tomokazu Harimoto. You forget he's 17.
Yeah. Amazing how he took his time on that backhand there, just fed the ball through with the spin, used Phyllis's spin.
8 points in a row. Is he turning the screw here on Phyllis? It's not decisive, of course, if he takes this. It's a race to four, but well, this would be a hammer blow for the German. Two game points. One of them saved. Yeah, it's not, you know, it's you lose games, isn't it? I mean, the fact that he's been 8-2, mentally, it'll be tough to take if you can't save this. But Harimoto for once there misses out.
10-11.
Well, a moment of fortune, you've got to be honest, for Phyllis there with that drop in. I mean, Harimoto wasn't expecting this at all. This one coming up.
Harimoto almost got that there.
Yeah, almost.
This brilliant shot there from Harimoto, taking it so early with so much pace. He's not given Ruin time to set for his defensive shot.
No, a shake of the head like that again, I think, Phyllis.
It was loaded. Harimoto received back all of Ruin's spin from his previous backspin chop.
Third game point. Well played.
Yeah, how about that for a receive? Kind of around the side of the ball, so it's got topspin. So Harimoto pushed it. And then Phyllis there with the twiddle, forehand attack. Levels the scoreline, 12 all.
And another towel down here. You can't shake the feeling, really, this is going to go a long way, deciding the outcome of this final. Both having had the chances now, that difference 3-0, or back to 2-1. Huge.
Whoa.
Phyllis there served with the long pimple rubber as well. It's the first time Harimoto's attempted his backhand against the defensive chop from Phyllis.
Oh, he's taking 14, it.
12, game to Phyllis.
Ruin Phyllis back into this final. Takes the third game of this one. 14 points to 12, saving game points along the way. And it's very much game on here in Doha.
It's game on indeed. Very gutsy, clever shot there from Ruin at the end there. Coming around the side of the ball, it came high, but tons of topspin, and it just caught Harimoto off guard. We might see that receive a lot more now going into this fourth.
He's got something to work with now, Ruin Phyllis. Led, of course, in the second, 8-4, lost it. And, of course, had led there again. He'd led 8-2. And then Harimoto came to game point. So that's a really good effort from Phyllis to go on and win the game, considering what had gone on before. And still in charge, Harimoto, but more questions to ponder, perhaps, as you say, with a couple of the tactical areas of the game as well. Things to watch heading into the fourth game and beyond here. A fantastic arena, of course, the brand new WTT arena, the blue on black, of course, the black flooring, and the blue colours popping around, signifying the contender series. We've had the contender event last week, the star contender this. So we've got different colours signifying the different levels in the world table tennis structure. More of information on that, of course, you can find at the official website. Those events, of course, to be unveiled, played for the first time in the months to come, hopefully.
One love.
Yeah, a key game for me, that last game there from Ruin Phyllis. I think if he'd have lost that one, 3-0 down, it'd just airway at him. After being up twice.
Love two.
Harimoto coming out strong out the blocks. And again, finding that forehand of Phyllis going out wide.
No, it's long. Catch the edge there from Harimoto. Again, more of the rallies we kind of expected in this matchup. Phyllis chopping there.
Two on.
Just clipped the net,
yeah. I'm just getting the impression a little bit here. Harimoto's getting a bit more... not full-on flustered, but just getting a bit more unsettled. He started the match so well.
Oh, yeah, he's definitely thinking about it a lot more.
Oh, only just. He's going to work so much harder to win these points now, Harimoto.
Yeah, he took this last one so early. Phyllis done well to get that one, but the last one was a bit too much. Seeing some mistakes here from Harimoto, just misreading the spin. And this is the art of a defensive player, especially a defensive attacking player. Mixing up the spin often means the attacker's going to make some unforced errors, you know, not always be completely clean with the shot. And that's what Phyllis has got to do. Harimoto done so well to smash this ball here. Phyllis got so much loop and height on the ball. And to the white line, you have to jump for it.
Let. 3-4.
Net serve.
Points against the service there. Service to come here for Harimoto in this fourth game. Well, that's where he can surprise. Phyllis does take that on, but he can't make it. Not this time.
That was quite risky, that was, from Phyllis, to be fair. Maybe could have just kept chopping there and stay in the point.
He's, as you pointed out before, Danny, so good, Harimoto, going again and again. I mean, these balls are not easy at all out of the light, just hanging with very little on them, or they're coming off the pips, they're moving around, dropping from a great height. Handles it all so well, Harimoto.
Yeah, very well.
That's the edge of the blade there.
That's the feeling on Harimoto here. He's filled the spin through on Phyllis, so it's kicked through. All of Phyllis's spin has come back at him. Harimoto is doing so well with this tactic, playing out wide to Phyllis very early on.
Question of what Phyllis can do to turn that round, especially on the receive. Right, as you say, directing a lot of traffic there. Oh,
5-9.
Yeah. He's made that high tariff shot for Phyllis. Does like taking it on, doesn't he, on the backhand side? Really likes taking risk there.
Nice class. It's key. It's what's got Phyllis to this final. His attacking ability. Oh, what a touch.
He's done him there.
The feeling to touch the ball like that. I mean, Phyllis technically did a long serve as well. To be able to control the ball.
11-5, game
and there
Harimoto.
Is the fourth game here for Harimoto. Is he moving in on the title? One more game required.
Yeah, good pressure from Harimoto throughout that game. Finding the wide forehand of Phyllis so often. Actually ended up Phyllis heading to lob so much. I'm sure Harimoto will stick to that.
Yep, restoring order from his point of view there. 3-1 up now, Harimoto needing just one more game, of course, to win WTT Star Contender Doha. That's what they're playing for, of course, in addition to $25,000 to the winner. Just have a look there, those wonderful trophies. I think they're going to become iconic. So the players, you mentioned some of the players already looking at them who've won them, and other players have said, yeah, I wouldn't mind having one of those at home.
They look very sleek, and I like the, I just love the W imprint on top, how it all molds in, like it's very custom, and yeah, I wouldn't mind one.
Yeah, it kind of underlines what the rebrand and everything is all about here with World Table Tennis, taking the sport forward, modern, fresh, vibrant look. But you've got to have the matches complementing all of that, and that's what we've had in these 10 days. So many thrilling, memorable encounters. Of course, Tomokazu Harimoto, specifically Ru and Phyllis this week, has provided those. Has he possibly got one more left here? Or is this too much at 3-1 down? Let's find out.
I think we've got to see Phyllis using more of, trying to get the ball more wide to Harimoto's forehand at the start of the point. Going into the backhand, Harimoto's turning very quickly and playing the forehand. He's going unsettled here, 3-0 start.
A couple of mistakes on the forehand side from Harimoto here. Extends the lead for Phyllis.
You see, Phyllis has imposed his game very well in his first few points. In the previous game, it was Harimoto playing wide to the forehand of Phyllis. You know, these rallies won't really take in place, and these are the ones that Phyllis can win the point on.
He's controlling this fifth game, but Phyllis, of course, will not be getting carried away. Look at earlier in the match, the leads that he's had have been greater than this. But as we say, he has just wrestled back a little bit of initiative sometimes in some of these rallies, how they're being played out. That will encourage him.
One set.
Harimoto, a rush of errors here.
Well, Harimoto's not too sure now where Phyllis is receiving. So he's protecting his backhand side, so he's using the backhand there. And we've seen a few times Harimoto struggled to use his backhand against this long pimple chop.
Yeah, because if you think back over the event, Harimoto, I mean, his backhand's been the, you know, the standout. We call it stock shot, but I mean, it's been more than that. It's been deadly at times. But of course, it's a very different matchup. Hasn't been, well, we haven't spoken about it quite so much.
The thing is, it's a lot harder to use a backhand against the chop ball than a forehand. The forehand's got bigger motion. You can get more acceleration and racket speed.
Yeah.
And with the amount of backspin that Phyllis is producing. This is one thing I noticed with Dimitri's game against Harimoto. Harimoto's really improved his block. So Phyllis there, he's hit a really good shot. You think he's won the point here, really. But Harimoto's got very good at just standing still and just blocking the ball back. And decent quality. The amount of times he wins the point like that now.
4-7.
This is a young man, of course, who burst on the scene. He's won the grand finals, the titles as well, big titles, but got to keep adding to your game. And you've identified an area there, maybe where opponents would have got to him in the past. Tougher to do that now. And then, of course, there's the firepower that Harimoto's always possessed in abundance. See, ripping the ball here.
5.
Slow, heavy spin there. Phyllis couldn't keep the ball down. Fantastic forehand topspin from Harimoto, changing the pace. Not always playing strong and fast out into the forehand, mixing the spin.
It's the variety in that forehand. Because as you say, the backhand's been a shot. You know, you think of his earlier matches, the matchup, Nyana Sekeren, Aruna, these guys. Of course, he's used his backhand, but here,
6-9.
Although there have been more mistakes, it's been the variety of the forehand that stood out with the Japanese.
Yeah. Good receive here from Phyllis, keeping the ball low. Makes it harder for Harimoto to make that quick attack.
Well, there are more balls coming back now.
Yeah.
And it's draining even for Harimoto here to keep winding up, injecting that pace.
The longer a rally goes on, the longer a point goes on, the longer a match goes on, for an attacker against defender, it always becomes harder.
10-7.
It's more of a flick that time on the forehand side.
It just clipped the edge there, didn't it?
Yeah, and it's a wind-up, obviously, but it's just the way he contacted. It was like a flick. Second game point. I apologise, he's caught the net on the way through, but Ruben Phyllis went out in front early there, and this time he wasn't caught. He's still very much alive here in Doha, the German, now trailing 3-2.
Yeah, much better set there from Phyllis. Mixing the ball up, mixing his play. He's able to dictate his game on Harimoto there by being more aggressive on the first balls. And just mixing up the receive, so Harimoto didn't just keep pivoting and just dictating by playing wide to the forehand to Phyllis.
Harimoto, of course, trying to follow Mima Ito's example earlier in the women's final, top-seeded Japanese coming through for the title. And he's still in a good place to do it. He's still 3-2 up. There will be a few more moments, thoughts, doubts, you know, kind of creeping in there with that last game that we just saw from Ruben Phyllis. Still in charge though, still 3-2 up. See whether he can match Ito's achievements. Ito absolutely incredible really these 10 days in Doha, winning both women's singles titles. Just the one defeat in fact, alongside Mizutani in the mix. Other than that, it was just win, win, win.
Sixth game, Harimoto to serve.
Harimoto of course losing in the semis of the contender event last week to Dmitry Ovcharov. From two up, he was lost that 4-2, of course, different trajectory to this match now, but he won the first couple here.
And this is absolutely key for Ruben Phyllis right now to get a few points ahead, unsettle Harimoto. I think you'll feel as soon as Harimoto gets a slight lead here, it's going to be very, very tough for Ruben.
One on.
It's a clever long fast serve from Harimoto there, opening the play and playing quickly to Ruben so he doesn't have time to get in position to chop the ball.
Two on.
Just so much backspin on the ball from Phyllis. Harimoto done well there. Phyllis there, a tricky receive, but Harimoto's backhand there, just all over it. Open bat angle, straight through the ball.
Tried to twiddle there. He tried to come round and switch it up, as he often does, but the accuracy wasn't there on that occasion for the German.
It's interesting because Phyllis hasn't won many points on that backhand side. Mm.
It's quite risky, isn't it?
Maybe it doesn't need to.
Mm.
Yeah.
giving it everything, Phyllis, there from way back.
Harimoto is doing well to smash those. They're such deep lobs.
It's not just the muscle, it is the attention to detail every time. And he picks the service there. Easy does it for Harimoto.
Yeah, done so well there, took the pace off it, took his time. And that deception on the forehand, it looks like his forehand's going cross court. Just changing his angle and contact.
Oh, another one. Just that uncertainty about this, even at this point, even with Harimoto ahead, that you feel maybe this isn't quite done yet in his favour. Oh. He's able to wind up the forehand this time. I've seen so much of it from Phyllis in recent times, but that one, he's got that back.
Phyllis had to twiddle twice there to get him ready. So watch the twiddle, and again. Wow. Because he thought he was coming to the backhand, so he's twiddled for the backhand. He then realised he comes to the forehand, so he twiddled for that.
Timeout called by Yosuke Kurashima here. Both timeouts used now. A little bit of a different look now from Phyllis. He's a bit more out in front here. Yeah.
Phyllis. 5-6.
Big point this one after the timeout. Slightly hesitant there, Harimoto.
His trusty backhand lets him down. Of course, you go back, as I say, different situation, but you go back to last week in the semi-finals. He was two up on Dmitry Ovcharov and lost 4-2 from there. He knows here that this could easily, if he's not careful, go to a deciding seventh game.
That was clever. See, this is what I said earlier. If Ruin plays wide to the forehand of Harimoto, he can't seem to get the same amount of power on the first ball because Harimoto's setting himself ready for the forehand from the backhand corner.
So he's got to move across, first of all, mate. Yeah. And therefore, he isn't as well set as early.
And he... Oh!
Oh! Oh. That's unfortunate for Phyllis. It really is.
That's a crazy... Yeah. Oh.
Let's off for Harimoto there. Gets it just right there. Back on track that time, Harimoto.
Yeah, got the switch into the forehand. Phyllis just couldn't read how much spin was on it. He tried guiding it through.
Coming off the pips there?
Yeah, off the pimples. Reversing the spin, just having Harimoto guess, really, what's on it. And that little bit of hesitation causes the weak return.
Yeah, well described. It did. It just came across as a hesitant shot from Harimoto, and you can't say that about him too often. Nothing hesitant about that. Ferocious.
It's a clever serve from Harimoto. Long, fast. Straight away, get that ball into the forehand corner of Phyllis.
we know that he's the real deal, Harimoto. He's shown that over a number of years. But if he can win this title, big moment surely in his career. And he's very close now. He was the youngest Grand Finals champion, remember, just 15 years of age. A lot of youngest ever records set by Harimoto. And he's still only 17. But he continues to improve. And he's almost home here. Two match points. Tomokazu Harimoto is the WTT star contender, Doha champion. He's had to dig deep there, he's had to work hard, but he's seen off Ruan Phillis, the surprise finalist, in six games in the end. Harimoto dominant in Doha.